Welcome to Arrak's Life. My name is Francis. This is the Painted World of Ariamus. Ariamus? Yeah. So that is where we are. We are inside the painting. And we are going to explore the very lovely secret level thingy that is full of dead people. And the secret path that looks like it's sketchy. We're not going to go that way. Oh, there's something over there. I do kind of want to see what's going on. Alright, we better check it out. But I figured this out. There's a bonfire, like, right here. We have no humanity. We're gonna rest. This is the only bonfire on the level. So we're gonna rest here. And then we're gonna check out what's going on with the secret area. Cool. That's pretty neat. Glad we did that. So the Painted World of Ariamus is interesting. The first thing you'll notice is that there's giant, ravens, crows maybe, and corpses all over the place. Which is a sign of life. But mostly death. And the inhabitants are, hollowed to start. But you'll notice they're quite a bit tougher than the Hollows we fought earlier. Some of them taking 2 one-handed hits to kill rather than just the gentle brush of love. Triprojectile. Oh yeah, there's a hanging body up there. I believe you can knock down with some sort of arrow. But as we don't have an arrow, we actually do have a bow, but I'm not willing. Well, alright. We're here now. I talked about it. It takes a few seconds. We might as well see what it is. The tricky thing is you never know if it's going to be just another thing or if it's like a thing that could be useful. It says we don't have the stats to use it, but I think we can still shoot it. He just misses poorly. Does it really just go through things if you don't have enough skill? You think it'd still be able to hit it, like whether you're good with it or not. If you shoot a thing, the arrow hits it. Oh, you have to hit the rope. That is stupid. Okay. Anyways, one humanity. Brilliant. Glad we went through all that. Right. As it starts out, our goal in this area is basically just to get out. You'll have noticed on the bridge that we started at, there was no, like, little painting back. We're gonna have to find the way out, and that's basically the whole goal of the level is welcome. Try and find the way out. There's a secret sort of staircase here. We'll go up, see what's going on. It's a little maze-like, I think. There's a sort of this desecrated town area. So there's quite a few winding alleys and staircases and what have you. There's a few items that are worth picking up, I think. Some snowy barrels. You'll need to break those in order to maximize the damage done to your graphics card. A dried finger. That's a good drop, I think. Alright, we're getting to running. Nope. That was not a running jump. And I have no idea where we are. Let's go down. Oh, there's a giant albino rat. I don't think the albino rats do anything special. Actually, they might do toxin instead of poison. I don't know that for sure. Oh, hello. Unfortunately, okay. So these are the guys that are the reason why this level is difficult. Honestly, if it weren't for the bubbly hollows, this wouldn't even be that bad. But they do exist, and so it is difficult. The halberd really is the optimal weapon, because what these guys do is toxic damage when they die. So you catch them adrift with the halberd, you stay far away, you poke at them, life is good. If you're a sword user, you know, some sort of dagger, backstabbing kind of gentleman or woman, you will find these encounters to be difficult because I have done a sword run, and it sucks. Wizards as well, you'll find you'll have quite a nice advantage in this section. Being able to shoot off spells, even just on those guys, and then using your dagger on the hollows is way nicer than having to piss about with your sword. We are in luck as a halberd user. I should be okay. Obviously, you can still make the mistake of getting too close. Like that would have been if that was a kill. It's only the kill blow that sends the toxin everywhere, but still, we need to be careful. Yeah, just like that. Should be fine. They also spit fireballs at us, which is not very friendly. And this guy's getting actually awfully close, which I don't like particularly. There we go. Alright, we seem to be doing okay right now. I see one more above us, and I'm just sort of hoping he doesn't come down. This guy, he's got a strategy. It's not a good one, but it is a strategy. Okay. We are doing just fine. I should actually equip some of that. I think we have at least two more purple flower mosses, and I should equip them just in case I do get toxins, and then I'm not shifting through my inventory for a good half hour. That's a toxin. That's gonna be close. So that would be intelligent, but I am not that smart, unfortunately. Gonna throw that down there. We'll pick it up later. My sort of plan of attack for this level is to clear the upper floors first. You know, we're gonna sort of loop around, knock out the buildings, and then we'll take the sort of city streets out. It's more of a town, really. We'll take the town streets out. But that's part of that. Jumps like that are why having a medium roll is just too important to give up. Like, not being able to get somewhere, and then you either have to strip or, you know. That's basically your only option if you want to make a jump like that otherwise, is to take off your clothes and then you're faffing around. You might as well just have yourself set up in a good position. I don't know why these rats, they don't seem to have the best combat instinct. You know, like, they're like booze. They just turn around and try not to look at you. I don't know what's up with that. There's a chest. Looks friendly. Oh, that is the, American Ninja Warrior outfit. I forgot what I was calling them. Good luck. Thank you. Okay. This looks like one of those invisible walls, but it isn't. So we do not need to worry about it. I guess this is just a dead end. I'm not too suspicious of dead ends on this level, because as I explained, it does have all this sort of alleyways and whatnot, so a dead end isn't really an unusual thing. It's kind of just part of it. I'm not going to spend too much time faffing around with every little divot. Okay, we're going to want to keep heading across. I can see this guy here, he's hanging out. Yeah, you fall down. No? Usually if you hit them while they're hanging, they'll fall, but I guess not if you miss horribly. Okay. Ooh, that is a scary thing in the backdrop. We will get to that. And this is the staircase down to the street level. And I think this sort of just loops around. Yeah, there's a few extra items to pick up. Ah, we shouldn't have done that. Well, it's what I get, I guess, for snooping around. I got greedy and I'm gonna pay for it now. Unless there's an easy way up, which I somehow... Yeah, we kind of need to get back up there, which is unfortunate given our circumstance. That doesn't look like a good place to be. Neither does that. Somewhere there should be maybe a path that isn't terrible. Honestly don't know. I don't know how meant we were. That's not a good way to structure a sentence. I don't know if we were really meant to come down here. There was a drop, but every drop out of the drop looks perilous. Which is bad. I mean, that is just a death sentence. Alright, I guess we're making a hefty spring. Go for it. And then we'll see what's over here. Ha ha. How we misjudge that path. It is not a dead end. In fact, it is a loop. Okay. Let's go see that giant mysterious blob now. Here. Now, if you look down that way, there is some loot, and you'll see that giant corpse of a bird. We will go there. That is not something we will miss, but I'm gonna walk away for now, because there's some combat to deal with over there, and right now we have naked bird ladies to combat. We will make them our priority. I didn't like that attack either. That was annoying. Just because I lowered my shield, I guess. Oh, but that damage does not seem good at all. So I guess just avoid the jumps at all costs. Yeah, 93. That is not good damage at all. There we go. I'm not liking our odds on like two or three of those guys. Those are the stairs up. We're not really set to go that way yet. Okay, this is not a bonfire. I don't. The reading those notes have never helped anyone. This door is locked still. That way does lead to the bonfire, technically speaking. But it is not by any means the effective route to take to get there. No, we want to... Wait, what? Did I say bonfire? Shoot, I was thinking about the bonfire while I was talking. That is the way out of the level. But it is currently semi-blocked at the moment. We have to do some more stuff before we can actually get through that way, even though we can technically go through the fog wall. And this is unfortunate. I'm hoping she falls. Oh, bastard. Yeah, that was unfortunate. Yeah, that's not good. Now we got all these guys again. Let's just try and run through these guys quickly here. Excuse me. And I do mean run through them. No patience, kinda. Sprint through the bad guys deal. That is one of these skills in Dark Souls you will pick up really well if you're really bad at the game. Which is just to run through the mobs. Honestly, the first time I played through it, it was like, what are you really good at? Getting past all the enemies. Like, I could sprint past them super well. Oh, but the souls are gonna be in the last safe place I was. Oh, wait a minute, I think I've got this messed up. Because that doesn't make any sense. This door... Yeah, okay, I'm an idiot. That's why I was lost, like a moron. That door leads to the end of the level, and it's locked. The fog door leads to the place that I'm trying to get to. That is... I'm really stupid. Because I was explaining it poorly, too, and it wasn't making sense in my head. I'm like, the fog gate's locked somehow, but... You know, like, no, it's not. Because it's not where the level exit is. They're my souls, way up there. Lord knows how I'm gonna get up to them with bird brains in the way. And they keep doing the jump of death on me. Oh, and now we got all the guys I ran away from coming up from behind. And I kinda want the 16,000 souls I dropped up there. If only there was monster id fighting where they'd, you know, Doom style just start gacking each other. Okay. Let's go get those souls, and then we're gonna get out of here. Except for this guy, who has now decided that he will personally be a nuisance to me. So, thank you to that guy. Taking the time out of your day to make mine difficult. Honestly, we might as well just finish. This staircase up here is a dead end. We're already halfway up now. As long as we don't fall like a moron. I don't know why the game is lagging either. It shouldn't be. It's a little strange. My settings have not changed since the last time that I did this. Actually, that seems like a good strategy. Let's knock him off the air. We're not both going. A little worried because I see a crow lady up there and I don't want her to jump me when I get to the top. I wouldn't imagine she can jump that far. Red sign, soapstone. Okay. We're actually never going to use that, but for sake of completeness, it was probably a good thing to pick up. Opposite of the white soapstone we got in the beginning with Solaire, where you can put that down and then have people help you. You put down the red soapstone and you can PvP people. So, that's good. We will be doing as little PvP as possible, as I am not very good at the PvP, and I will get killed very poorly. Okay, now let's actually go the right way and stop mucking things up. Aha. Yes, this is where I want to be. Oh dear. There's this sort of legion in the middle, and maybe we'll fight them. It's not worth doing it right now. We're just gonna head through here and get back to the bonfire.